A 43-year-old man is charged with murder 25 years after the crime was committed.
Edgar Ortega was in Mexico but was back in Chicago today to face first-degree murder charges. WGN's Mike Lowe is joining us now with more on this story. Mike.
And good afternoon to both of you. This is really an extraordinary story of a family's 25-year wait for justice in what was described as a senseless gang killing of an innocent teenager.
This picture of my brother, 18 years old.
Sometimes the things we carry are heavier than they seem.
I've had it in my wallet ever since I had a wallet. So,
for Eddie Santiago, a cherished photo of his older brother represents both a searing memory and a search for justice.
We waited a long time for this. And now, finally, justice. That's all I want. I can't bring him back.
It's been 25 years since Richard Montclair was murdered just one block from his home on the southwest side. This was Eddie 25 years ago, a day after his brother was killed.
I just hate the gangbangers because they killed my brother.
And this is Eddie today.
As a 9-year-old kid, you know, it's hard to process those things.
At the time, Chicago police said the 18-year-old recent high school grad
graduated high school, Bogan, went to prom, and that was it.
Was standing up to gang members. His mother remembers gang members had been harassing and intimidating people in his neighborhood.
And you know, he just wanted to keep the gangs out, away from our family.
It was noted in a yellowed Sun-Times article from 25 years ago that Richard died protecting his sister.
Rick was trying to protect more than his sister, his brothers. He was trying to protect the whole neighborhood. He was that kind of kid. He hated the gangs, and he let them know it.
You know, he just tried to keep her away. You know, but in the meantime...
It all led to a confrontation in December of 1993.
Richard Montclair fell mortally wounded to the ground with a gunshot wound that struck him through the heart.
Witnesses and police identified Edgar Ortega as the suspect and issued a warrant for his arrest.
Chicago detectives learned the defendant fled to Mexico where he had family.
The murder went unsolved for a quarter century until this week when authorities say now 43-year-old Ortega turned himself in, returning to Chicago to face first-degree murder charges. The things we carry aren't always tangible. For Montclair's mother, it's the burden of a broken heart.
I may not have my son here, but you know what? He's in there. And that's what matters to me. He's going to pay the price.
And it is unclear what led Ortega to turn himself in. His attorney says he had been teaching English in Mexico. He arrived in the U.S. this week. The judge today denied bond in this case, calling him a flight risk. Ortega will next appear in court again later in the month, March 26th.
What a story. And the pain still so raw, even 25 years later.
The brother Eddie that we talked to said all he can remember is running out of the house and seeing those flashing lights, and his uncle tackled him so that he couldn't see his dead brother's body lying there in the street.
Oh, wow. Incredible story. Thank you so much,
Thanks, Mike,
for telling it.